I'm Renee, so I'm a water treatment operator here at the Mount Grand Water Treatment Plant based in Dunedin. I've been working as an operator for about coming up to 2 years now. It's been quite an exciting change of career, so it's my second professional career and a nice fresh start. Lots of variety in the job, from just day-to-day operations of the plant to dealing with lots of varying issues that can occur in a water treatment plant and the processes, and a lot of fault finding and responding to those issues. So going to be on the spot thinking, but it's also very satisfying knowing that what I'm doing has a direct influence on the people of Dunedin, making sure that their water is clean, clear, safe, odourless. So we're running a DEF plant here. So what we're standing on now is the parallel plate separator. So this is our water's initial screening point before going through the plant. After here, it moves over into the building off to my left, where most of the turbidity and dissolved organics get taken out of the water before moving down to our AVG sand filters. So this is our DEF room. So on either side of me, we've got our mixing tank. So that's mixing in our chemical that we're using to treat the water, making sure it gets a thorough mix before it moves through to our DEF process, which is down here. The way the DEF works is there's dissolved air that's going to lift all of the turbid water, all of the sludge to the top, and allow us to remove it from the water before it goes to the filters. Here, we've got all this brown stuff coming to the top, so that's all going to get scraped off so that none of that goes through the filters. So we're here in the middle level of our DEF now. So here we can see the saturated air that dissolved here that's been released to lift all that brown stuff that we saw earlier up to the top. So it makes it all float, makes it positively buoyant so that the scrapers can remove it before heading to the filter process. After our filters, the water's coming out nice and clear. We dose with chlorine and a bit of lime to bring up the pH, and then it moves over to our X tanks, ready for the public consumption. So the day-to-day roles, we've got our routine work that we do each and every day. Anything from doing chlorine sampling to doing small labs. As a water treatment operator, we all have a portion of lab work that we do each day. So each of our water treatment plants is outfitted with its own laboratory. We do various different tests, such as testing for silica levels, sulfate, checking our alkalinities on our raw and treated water systems. And making sure that everything's within the parameters that we are trying to keep. So we'll do a wee chlorine test right now. We hand our chlorine analyzer. Just general checking of equipment and pumps, making a bit of fault finding. So this is one of our colour meters. This is for the one, the pipeline coming into the plant, so we can see what's coming ahead of time. So whether we've got water coming from the catchment or water coming from our raw water reservoir, this will pick up and tell us what the colour is so we can get ready for the treatment process. So what we're going to do is just give it a wee pull apart and give it a wee clean. And then we have a lot of kind of variables that pop up, such as breakdowns that we have to do a bit of trial and error to find the issues for sometimes. So it can be quite challenging. So anytime before we're interacting with our chlorine gas, we wear our BA kits. So BA stands for breathing apparatus, similar to what you see the firefighters wearing. So it makes sure that we're not breathing any of the harmful gas in if there happens to be any leaks. Pretty unlikely, but it's just in case. Quite a lot of variety to the job. So this is just one of our 6 water treatment plants in Dunedin. So we spend a bit of time going around the other plants, maintaining them as well, and making sure that Dunedin's population has nice clean drinking water. We're here in the control room now at Mount Grand. So this is our kind of control computer using SCADA. So this is what allows us to control the plant. Most of it is automated, so it generally just produces water as it goes. But we can kind of keep an eye on things here by looking at, for the most part, trends. So we can kind of look at what things are doing. So the colour of the water coming into the plant, for example, is pretty stable here at the moment, a few wee jumps. Also the water's temperature, so on and so forth. We can keep an eye on up in the depth, what's going on, whether our treatment process is working efficiently or not. And based on that information from what we find looking at the trends, we'll make adjustments to the treatment process to get things working smoothly. Other things we've got is we've got our kind of our chlorine residuals and our pH residuals at the end of the process to make sure that before the water leaves out to reticulation for consumption, but it's got the appropriate amount of chlorine in it for disinfection, so it's nice and safe to drink. So upcoming challenges and so on and so forth are things like we've got a lot of aging infrastructure. So a lot of things need to be upgraded to keep up with the standard of water that we want to be sending to the public. Some interesting things coming up, like the Three Waters Reform. So it's going to be really interesting to find out how that plays out and what changes there's going to be in the roles. I'd highly recommend this job for anyone who likes to kind of keep on their toes, likes a good bit of variety in their job, and really wants that satisfaction from a working environment. Advice I could give to anyone trying to get into the role would be do a bit of research into the plants in your area, and just apply. I applied for this role 3 times before I got it, so perseverance is key.